Hello and welcome to another instalment of Tom's Viral. We're on the Banks today.
What's up? We're not calling it Tom's Viral anymore.
What do you mean?
Mate, we spoke about this. We had a meeting.
I thought that was all a joke.
Mate, we weren't winding you up. Like, we're changing the name of it.
Ah, f*** this for a minute.
Wait, nah, Tommy, don't be like that.
I thought you were joking.
We weren't joking. Oi, Tommy. Oi. Tommy. Oh, for God's sake. Tommy.
Hello, I am Tom Foreman. Welcome to Life at Nash. Dan's decided to ruin it and change the name by... On a serious note, we have decided to change the name to Life at Nash. Reason being, it's not just me anymore. There's loads of us in the office now, all getting up to their own sort of individual things. I guess it is just everyone's Life at Nash. So what's coming up in this episode? Well, we're going to check out some brilliant bit of footage from a good friend Reedy's trip to the famous Rainbow Lake back in the summer.
What a unit.
We let Les loose with a camcorder for some behind-the-scenes show footage.
Hi guys, I spoke to you earlier.
We catch up with a few of the lads on another foreign shop day adventure.
Chunk.
We've got new boy Max Hendry undertaking the Ballmaker challenge.
Here he is.
Easy now.
A little bit of footage from one of the stockings on Kevin's Lake.
Yeah.
And we'll be hearing from Alan, where he'll be revealing his new, very secret wonder rig.
I don't think there's a better rig out there at the moment than this.
That is not to be missed. After watching the recently released Urban Banx, me and Dan thought, yeah, we can do this. So we decided to go on a little road trip of our own, see good friend Jordan Dix down at Bristol Angling Centre. We popped into the shop for a quick brew before heading to his new lake, which he's kindly let us do a couple of nights fishing on. All we needed was a bit of drum and bass.
I don't know how you do what you do.
Munch a Burger King.
What you got there?
Garlic and parsley king prawns.
Most importantly, catch some fish.
Yes. Get me a bit.
Well, that didn't last long. Anyway, it's the second morning now. The sun's come up and I'm going to do another lap of the lake to see if I can see any fish.
Hi mate, you right?
Hello mate, you right?
I can't believe I've never been here, mate.
Yes, it's the first day.
Yo!
You alright?
Yeah, sweet.
Hello, mate.
Yes, daddy.
You good?
Yeah, man, you?
Yeah.
I've been good mates with George for years now, but never actually visited the shop for myself, so it was good to get a guided tour, and whilst there, he showed us a map of the lake and a few likely looking
this
spots.
This corner here, if you get down there, this corner here, there's some reeds here.
We then grabbed a few last minute bits and got back on the road.
Got the bits.
Next up.
Supermarket.
Next up.
Lake.
Fishing.
We've just got to find out where we're going.
Fishing has been delayed.
Fishing.
I know what you're thinking. Game changer. Anyway, done my lap of the lake. Did actually find a couple of fish in one of the bays, so I'm going to get a rod set up now and see if we can stalk one. So, we're smack bang in the middle of show season. We've had a couple already, both in the UK and abroad. Someone, Dan, decided to let Les loose with a camcorder and film some behind the scenes Les Cam show footage. Warning, The following section may have scenes of bad camera work, poor audio and extreme close-ups of Les Webster.
Morning everyone, here we are. Gonna go and set Sandown up.
Told ya.
Really early in the morning, a few of the lads in already.
Let's go.
Three. One of the most important jobs of the day, making tea. All right, Ian.
Morning all, mate.
Ready to go? Ready to go, lads? So we're definitely ready now.
What are you doing?
Getting ready to set up. Just pulled up. I'll show you the hall this time, and I'll show you while we're setting up. The next time I show you, it'll be full up.
We pride ourselves with our show stands. It takes a lot of hard work, and despite our different job roles within the company, when it comes to a show, we all pitch together as a team.
Here's the team.
Work hard. Help each other out. Build a show stand we're all proud of.
Love the net and the net will love you.
Check it out.
Let me show you how far we're getting. There's that new match. Health and safety is best.
Abort.
Hi, another long day. We're all set up, ready to rock and roll.
Before you know it, the show's finished, the weekend's over, and we're packing down again. If you're planning on coming to visit us at any of the shows this year, be sure to come and check out the stand, come and say hello and have a chat. The remaining shows include Carping On at Five Lakes, the Northern Angling Show and the Big One at Farm Bar. Dates are on screen now. The dates are on. Anyway, let's get that rod out. So I've decided to come to this quiet corner of the lake. The sun's come back out and the wind swung this morning and is pushing gently into this bay. So it looks good for a bite basically. So I thought I'd come down here with one little sawn off and see if we can catch one. So as I said earlier, Jordan's kindly invited us to come down to Fisher's Lake for a couple of days. It's been his project for the last couple of years now, I believe. And with a lot of hard work from himself and some of his friends, he's made it into what it is today. It's a lovely little mature, but intimate venue. It looks good now, so in the summer I imagine it just incredible. About 30 odd carp in, I believe, hand-picked carp, up to about 30 pounds at present, but they're packing on the weight. And his long-term goal to turn it into an exclusive lake booking venue with some beautiful carp in. So as well as the shows in the UK, we also attend several events all across Europe. Back in the autumn, Dan, Mikey and consultant Chris Eagleston headed out to Belgium to the Conic shop, which is a big shop in Belgium. They put on a massive sort of open event. So the lads headed out to work at the event during the day, and then of an evening, they once again met up with Nash consultant and good friend Yella to do a spot of fishing. Alan even popped over for one of the days and was kindly given permission to do sort of some rig demos on the big river that's out the back of the shop. Despite the constant barge traffic and flow of pedestrians, in true Alan style, he managed to bag one. Check this out. No, okay, sorry.
And a big barge, just for good measure. Check it out. Yeah.
What's going on there, mate?
Wow. How's your luck?
It's one of them. Charles very kindly said, can you do some fishing? Of which I obliged, obviously. Didn't think it was going to rip off and nearly pull the rod in. And it has. Flicked a couple of baits out on this corner. Probably put 50, 60 freebies round it. And I've only gone and connected with one. Oi! Yeah. What a result. Out of the De Cognac show, having a lovely time demonstrating rigs and rods and bait, and it's only kind of rattled off. Thank you for your help, little man. Good fun? Yeah? So, time for lunch.
The other lads, however, decided to man a stand during the day and then come evening, go to fish a few local spots with Yella.
Hey. What's the show like?
Show's good, mate. It's been really, really busy this morning. Slowed down a bit now, sort of lunchtime, but it's going to pick up again this afternoon. A lot of people, the shop's absolutely rammed.
Great, and then what are we doing tonight?
Yeah, fishing.
Can you try?
Yeah. No problem.
Unfortunately, they blanked the first two nights and apparently had a close encounter with a couple of wild dogs. Sounds like a night out in Southend. Anyway.
What happened last night then, Mikey?
Well, one was an Alsatian, and I don't know what it was. These dogs were massive. And yeah, two stray dogs on their own. I've never seen a dog this big in my life. Two horses. Yeah, to be honest, I just hid under the covers and played dead, to be honest. It was a heartbeating moment, Dan. Dan thought he was gonna die. Don't know what it was, these dogs were massive.
Ooh, dogs, scary dogs, ooh, big dogs, ooh.
However, for all their hard work on the final morning, just as they were about to pack up and leave for their crossing, Dan managed to bag one. Go on, Dan.
Angry gobs.
That's you, mate. That's you. Go on, Danny. Go on. Come on,
that's a
that's
a unit, bro.
That's a
that's a unit, mate. Yes.
Carpy and Belgium.
Right, like, we're due to leave in what, an hour?
Yeah.
Spent all night, barely a peek, sitting having a brew. And away it went.
39 hours.
38, 40. 38, 14.
So last morning in Belgium, literally about an hour before we're about to go home. Show was done yesterday and after two blank nights fishing, rods rattled off and yeah, I'm absolutely speechless with this.
Absolutely buzzing for you, mate.
I'm over the moon.
Carlsberg did Monday morning.
Yeah.
Yes, Dan.
Cheers, boys.
Get in there, mate.
Key Cray, look.
It is on Key Cray.
Mother. Key Cray, mate.
So a couple of hours stalking, unfortunately didn't produce anything. It's late afternoon now, I've come back to my main swim and I'm gonna get the rods out and see what the night brings. Moving on, and what we've still got to bring you in this episode, recently new boy Max Hendry joined the team as our new Nash Bait brand manager after previously working at Advanced Carp Fishing magazine. Being a new boy, it was only right he competed in the famous Ballmaker challenge as his initiation. If you've watched previous episodes of Tom's viral life at Nash, you would have seen that Mikey is the reigning champion after beating Loz when he first joined the team.
Ballmaker's down.
Whoa. Yeah. So it's only right we put Max up against Mikey and see if he could take his title away from him.
Here he is.
Easy now.
Thank you, mate.
New boy Max has to have an initiation. So Max, it's traditional at Nash that the new boy has to do the Ballmaker challenge against the reigning champion, who at the moment is Man Like Wilson.
Man Like Wilson.
He beat young Lawrence Smart a couple of years ago now.
Yeah.
That's sweet.
He ain't got a chance, has he, really?
He ain't got a chance, mate.
Alright, I think we should get outside and get this going.
Yeah, go for it.
Is the consistency okay?
It's his funeral.
Just keep going like that, Bob. Oh, yeah, it's done. So, what we reckon then? It's like that, isn't it?
Whack.
Yeah.
Striker.
He's ready.
Tastes like someone's put a scope at Squid Boilie in my team. I knew they had as well, you know.
You are a bait expert, aren't you?
I drank half a cup and I was like, the first sip I was like, it tastes like scope, but it's good. But I kind of like it. And then I just carried on drinking.
It's good, it's good gear.
He loves a bit of bait.
Yeah.
Ready?
Good luck, mate.
Good luck, Gage. 3, 2, 1.
Yep. Oh, what's it called?
Max is panicking. He's panicking. Panicking's never good. Oh, it could be over already.
Oh, he's gone for a sloppy mix.
No. Did I say that?
Come on, Mike.
Oh, you're walking it, mate. Like you say, Bolt in the final.
Max has gone 70-30 in favour of water. Oh, that's a joke.
Showboating.
Careful, Wiz. He's coming back.
You know what? I'd hurry up with him,
actually. Move on there! Oh, I just see them and he's got in a bucket!
Nods, what are we doing for time?
6 seconds. Whoa. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Ballmaker's down! Ballmaker's down!
What's he's done look? Me, bruv! Like,
Wilson, that one don't count.
Oh,
ooh. I just stuck him in the
corner. What's going on there then? Do we give him that one? I'm going to give him that one.
Yeah, look at all these.
They're all a mess.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. No.
That's two.
That's an Easter egg.
9.5. These are, don't know what they are. They're not industry standard. How have you done that? I'm not giving him that one. 3, 4. No.
What did you do?
I'll give him that one. No.
Oh man.
I'll give him that one. No, I won't. a 9 and a very generous 5.
9,
very
5.
Very generous.
Yeah.
And still the remaining Ballmaker champion. Jesus Christ, Ben. They're solid as well.
Yeah, they are.
So despite his terrible ball making efforts, Max has fit right in the office and it's a pleasure to have him on board. In other exciting news, before Christmas we had a stocking into one of our new lakes with some lovely VS fifth shears fish. It was a minging horrible windy day, but we managed to get a little bit of footage, so check out some of the Nash Lakes fish of the future.
By Chris in this one. Tom's linear.
Certified banger.
Certified banger.
That's what he said on these scouts.
The stocking went really well. The best fish of the bunch being a huge 29 pound mirror, which we look forward to seeing again in the years to come.
So this is one of our VS Fishery C6s. This is one of the harrow strain fish. And she's it's the biggest fish we've ever produced on the farm in this age, so by about 3 pounds. So future's bright for this one going into Kevin's Lakes, and I think look forward to seeing it in a few years when it's massive.
Told ya. Game changer. Next up is good friend of mine and ex-Nash employee Nick Maddox, aka Reedy. He's now left Nash and runs the very successful Northern Angling Show, which means he only has to work one weekend of the year, giving him plenty more opportunity to go on some European fishing adventures. So he's always ringing me and texting me constantly going, "Oh, Tom." I get around to it. So he's always ringing me and texting me going, "Oh, Tom, made me famous, get me in front of the camera." So this time we thought we'd give him his opportunity, as he was off to Rainbow for 2 weeks with his old man.
Well, we've arrived at the lake safe and sound. Yeah, we're about to head round to the swim. Let's get a little view of the lake first. And there it is, Rainbow. Waited a long time to fish here, not as long as me old man, but yeah, we're here finally.
It didn't take really long to get in on the action, landing a few of Rainbow's smaller residents in the first couple of days. Despite the size, they were some lovely looking carp all the same.
I'm pleased to say that fish number three is just down there in the net. So, yeah. Oh, look at that. An angry 37-pound 4-ounce common from Rainbow.
A lovely misty morning, a lovely boat battle, and this one giving me the run around for a bit.
Morning. Well, thought I'd give you another little update. It's now Tuesday morning and I am on 6 fish so far, so really happy. I've had a 37 common, 35 mirror, and then 420. Don't think there's much more we can do, so yeah, just got to keep fishing through them and hope that a big one turns up.
The action continued throughout the week on Reedy's side of the swim, landing a few more carp, but it was his old man's first fish of the session where they came face to face with one of the real big ones.
Yep.
That's what we come to Rainbow for.
64 pounds of gnarly Rainbow mirror coming to the new Key Cray.
Well, what a sick buzz we've got going on this morning. Yeah, as you've just seen, that's at a 64-pound mirror. Yeah, it's what we came to Rainbow for a chunk. So, yeah, hopefully tomorrow morning or maybe even sooner than that might bring similar results. Well, this is certainly a lot more like what we came to Rainbow for. A moment ago, a 40-pound common. What a result, 59 pounds, 8 ounces. A proper kipper from a new spot that I found.
Yeah, not bad then,
yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
You got it, darling. Thank you. Mega. Well, it's now Monday morning, so going into the second week, and the tables are starting to turn, I'm pleased to report. Yeah, during the night last night, I had a 40-pound common off of one of the spots, and then, yeah, another rod was away, and that was a 59.5-pound mirror for myself. And then, yeah, off the same spot that Dad had the 64-pound mirror from yesterday, he's just had a common that's a bit of a chunk, so, yeah, we're just about to get that one out. Here's the prisoner. Not the longest fish in the world, but yeah, and I've got some shoulders on it.
Right, you want to head this end, don't
you? There you go.
Get his belly out, I can only see half of it. It looks about 30 pounds, here we go.
As if the 64-pounder wasn't enough for Reedy's dad, he went and topped it again, this common going over 72 pounds, once again on the Key Cray. and although throughout the second week they didn't manage another real big un, they continued to catch several good fish to over 50 pounds. An incredible fortnight's fishing for the both of them, and a huge well done from everyone here at Nash. Some really incredible angling from the Maddox camp.
Well, that's it. It's the final morning at Rainbow. Managed another 3 fish overnight, actually. Total now to 23. Dad's had 6 fish now, so that's 29 in total. But yeah, that's it. What a fantastic week it's been, and just what a beautiful place to be waking up. Just mega quiet. Absolutely love it, and hope that one day I'll be back.
Well, it's morning now. Unfortunately, I didn't catch anything during the night. It did get really cold, the temperature dropped, which probably didn't do us any favours. But we've got a couple of hours to go before we have to leave and head back to Essex, so there's still an opportunity. But as for now, it's the moment we've all been waiting for. It's time for Alan Blair to reveal his super secret rig, one that he's been working on for a few months now. He's been keeping it very hush-hush in the office. It's something you would have never seen before. This rig is most definitely going to put more fish on the bank for you. Check this out.
Okay, yes, it's not an amazing new wonder rig. It is the Ronnie rig, the swivel rig, whatever you want to call it. But I've started using it, and I've started using it for the right reasons. Up until probably 6 months ago, I've been an advocate user of the multi-rig. Yes, a huge amount of my fishing is done with a single pop-up, maybe a light scattering of bait around over the top. And yes, I use the chod rig an awful lot, but there are situations when the chod rig isn't the ideal rig for that scenario, and I prefer to fish with a lead clipper and the multi-rig. The multi-rig's been good to me. You know, you can change your hook, you can go to a smaller hook, a bigger hook, and I've caught an awful lot of fish on it, but there's always been something in the back of my mind saying it's not quite as effective as it could be, primarily because it hasn't got that 360 rotational element like a chod rig, for example, until I saw this. Yep, started seeing it in print, started seeing it in films, and immediately, you know, my ears pricked up and I started looking and listening and trying to understand it, and yeah, it is massively better than a multi-rig in my opinion. So I started using it, started catching a lot of fish, and a lot of banter in the office, a lot of the lads at work taking a mick out of me, hey, just following the crowd, like just like a flock of sheep, yeah, you're just the same as everyone else. But it wasn't that, you know, I'd noted it, I'd looked at it, and I genuinely believed it would, you know, bring an edge into my angling, and that's why I started using it. Only a few weeks ago, I was out with Max Hendry, exactly the same, you see me, ah, you're using the Ronnie rig just like everyone else. Kept my mouth shut, got about my fishing, I had 6 fish, and all of them were absolutely impaled, and Max sort of said to me humbly after, oh, yeah, looks like a really good rig. And he's since gone on to try it himself and managed to catch 2 really good fish, you know, for February, 2 30-pounders. So there you have it. That is the Ronnie rig, the swivelling rig, the low-line pop-up rig. Dead, dead simple to tie. I personally take a Fang X hook and clip it into a micro quick change swivel. Slide down onto the Shanker hook link sleeve slim, cut a little bit off the end just to make it the right size. Mount onto the hook a hook bait swivel, comes in a hook bait kit with a little hook bead. Tie my bait on, I tie a preformed loop depending on the size of the boilie, and that can then just slide up and down on there. And then a section of combi link, because it's a rig I'm using for casting, I like to fish with a combi link because it's a bit stiffer. If I was fishing over a really hard bottom, I'd use an even stiffer version. Bit of putty just to counterbalance that pop up on there. And there you have it. You know, if you want to fish a pop-up or a special hook bait low to the deck, I don't think there's a better rig out there at the moment than this. I'm not suggesting, you know, being a sheep is the right way to go about all your angling, just copying and following others. I'm just saying in certain situations, take note of what others around you are doing, you know, successful anglers. And if they are catching fish, there's usually a reason for it. Same with this. I took note, saw it as being a great rig and implemented it into my own fishing. Good luck with your fishing this spring.
Well, I failed. Story of my life. To be honest with you, it is still February. Yes, it's mild. Yes, it's warm. But if anything, it's too warm, I think. That sun, too sunny.
I mean, actually, in my defence, it did get cold last night, and that's, yeah, it did get chilly. I think the pressure was, I don't know what it was, I don't know, but it was high. I know, I'm going to go with high, definitely high. As for that beautiful southwesterly trickling into that bay, might have been a bit too much, to be honest with you. Those sheep, as for those sheep, too loud. Those pigs, you hear those pigs? I knew it was going to happen from the off with it. Flat tire, to be honest. Curse me. New van, first time out in a new van. It was all clean, look at it now. In fact, I think I was too organised, if anything. New bivvy, new buzz bars. Couldn't get them straight, that's why. That didn't help. As for your wood burner, that was too hot, too bright. I saw it, I could see it, definitely. It's not a game changer. If anything, it was just too picturesque, too quiet. It needed more anglers, more pressure. A 5 on pressure. It's too Somerset, too countryside. I'm an urban kind of guy. It was too small, to be fair. I'm better on bigger lake. Could have gone to a bigger lake. Don't do small lakes. I think that's more than adequate to wildfire on this session. In all seriousness, it's a lovely little place. Thank you, Jordan, for inviting us. We will most definitely be back in the summer. But that's it for now. Hope you've enjoyed watching, and we will see you again soon for more Tom's Viral.
Life at Nash, Tom.
Huh?
Life at Nash.
I'm not saying that. F*** that, man.